Today we're doing a deep dive on the Speedrum virtual instrument from Apisonic Labs. This is an MPC-style drum sampler, and it's really great. Let's check it out. And full disclosure, the developer of Speedrum contacted me to make a video and provided me a code for the full version of this plugin. Other than that, I haven't been paid anything to make this video. But I did still mark this video as containing paid promotion, just so you're aware. So let's start off with an overview of what you get with this plugin. Starting at the top left, we've got 16 pads. We actually have two banks of 16 pads, or we can set it up so that we can see all 32 samples all at once. Each of the pads has a effects section. Got distortion, filters, compressor, transient shaping, and every pad can have different settings. Below that, we have controls for velocity, how the velocity affects the volume, the pitch, or the filter cut, humanize options for adding variations as it's playing, as well as volume envelopes and pitch envelopes for each pad. Below the pads, we've got colors. The waveform button here below the pad color is for a drag and drop render. So any effects that you have applied, you can sample that and create a new file to re-import or use somewhere else. Under the setup page, you have a project folder that can override your global settings for where rendered files go. Retrigger modes, whether it restarts every time you play the button or polyphonic. For long samples, we have the option of one shots and note on. Mute, solo, volume, pan, and pitch. Like most advanced samplers, this also has cut groups, so you can make certain samples cut other certain samples. There are 8 groups and 2 drop-down menus to set that up. There's also a trigger function where you can have one pad trigger a second pad. And then we have pad output channel, 16 stereo outputs for this plugin, or 32 mono. In the bottom section, there are 3 tabs, layers, setup, and slicer. The layers section allows you to modify multiple samples within a single pad so that you have different volume, panning, pitch, filters. Here we have buttons for previous and next. So without opening up the menu, opening up a file browser at all, you've got access to more samples from a single pad, and also a random button that's going to take from the same folder. On the setup page, we can set up our MIDi mapping. And then there's also a loop slicer, which makes it easy to grab a recording, split it up into different hits, and then import them into the grid of 32 samples. At the top, we've got a scaling function. So we can set this down to 60% or up to 200%. And in any size here, it's really nice and crisp. We have the option of saving this to a file as a Speedrum drum kit, which will have all the samples, all the effects settings, everything. The main menu has new and load options, importing kits from other samplers, saving the drum kit with samples, setting the outputs, and user guide, checking for updates, that sort of thing. File browser, and at the bottom, we've got some favorites list. So I've saved a few different folders as favorites. So if I can go to my TR-808 folder, my 707 folder, 909 folder, my folder of samples from that sound. And let's say I go to the 808 folder and I want to save the 606 to a favorites list here. All I have to do is right click on the empty slot or right click on any of the other slots to replace them. A left click will jump right to that folder. So as you can see, this plugin is optimized for quick workflow without being overwhelming with the amount of features. It's a very focused workflow. It doesn't have a sequencer and song arrangement built in. It doesn't have a full mixer built in. This one strips all of that away, and it's just pads going into the DAW with some filters and dynamic effects for each pad. Plus, it has layers. Plus, it has a sample slicer. Lots of great features, but not every feature totally trying to replace your DAW. I really like that and appreciate its focused design. let's grab two drum samples and I'll drag them in just like this. And you see, as I drag, it adds in additional numbers here. I have up to 8 layers. If I trigger the sample, both samples are playing at the same time. So that's on the all tight function where all samples are triggered simultaneously. We can switch this on the single sample mode. Only the highlighted one, in this case, layer 2, will play. If I switch this to layer 1, layer 1 plays. If we set this to round robin, then it will just alternate through each of these samples. Random. And for velocity, we have the option of splitting the velocities evenly based on the number of samples. Let's actually add in a couple more samples. So we got 4 samples. I'll set this to split evenly. And now based on the velocity, tapping on a pad where it's the top gives you a higher velocity. Tapping on the bottom creates a lower velocity. And so it's playing different samples based on the velocity. So if you have a realistic sounding snare that you've sampled with multiple velocities, you can set up your velocity layers like this and have a pretty realistic sound. In the menu here, we have delete, duplicate, normalize, reverse, export, and load in a sample into the slicer. On the setup page, we can set up our MIDI mapping. So you can see which notes are assigned to trigger each pad. To reassign, it's very simple. You just click on it. That will set it up for MIDI learn. And if we tap on it, that assigns it. So I'll just switch that back to C2. There we go. This can be a way to trigger multiple samples all at once. So this E2, let's change all these to F2, and now when I tap that, all 3 are triggered at the same time. And within the menu, you can save your customized map and load a customized map or set the current map as the default. In the main menu, there's additional things here for drag and drop defaults. Is it going to add a layer? Is it going to replace the first layer? I'll show you that. If we drag onto a sample that's already filled, it will add that as a new layer. But if you want to have that as replace, you can do that. So let me just delete this one. So now there's one sample there. If I drag in a symbol, and now that's replaced that pad with a new sample. You can select the pads with MIDI notes, reset output on pad reset, play pad on click, preview layer on click, default size, default layouts, alternative AB layout. That's what that looks like. What information is shown on the pads, the middle C octave, whether the pad color applies to the controls or not. So if I turn on the distortion, you can see that the controls are yellow. If I switch to pad that's colored red, you'll see that on the controls. And we can toggle that on and off to the default blue. Default pad color, a tiny fade, drag and drop render to a specific folder, and external audio editor option. Let's go through the process of creating a new drum kit. I'm just going to load my startup preset. All I've done is just pre-color the pads, and I'm going to go to a saved drum kit folder. And the kind of typical way of setting this up is having the kicks on the first row, the snares on the second row, the hi-hat on the third row, and then toms, cymbal crashes, miscellaneous sounds on the top row. I'm actually going to do slightly different. I want my F sharp key here to play the hi-hat. I want my A5 here, which is an E, to be my snare. And I want my C for my first pad. So let's do that kick. And then, yeah, this is a great opportunity to do layers. I do need to reset this. So I've got two layers, and I'm going to set this up to round robin, so it's just going to alternate. And then I'll grab a snare. I'll put that on there. And let's put this one there. And I'll just move that pad there, so just so it's a little easier to play. I want my hi-hats to cut each other, so I'll go to cut one, and I'll go to this one and cut one, and cut by, also cut by one on each of those. So a open hi-hat will override a closed hi-hat. A closed hi-hat will override an open hi-hat. So we haven't looked at the effects at all yet. Distortion starts out with a bit crushing distortion. There's also a kind of normal distortion shape. I actually don't know the details about what type of distortion this is. I would say that it's not exactly like a tape style or a tube style. Let's just say it's a wave shaper. And then there's also a ring mod. So lots of weird sounds you can get with the distortion effect. For filters, there are 12 types of filters: analog, low pass, band pass, and high pass, ladder, low pass, band pass, and high pass, with 12 or 24 dB per octave filter slopes. And each one obviously has a slightly different sound. With the compressor, we've got threshold, ratio, makeup, attack, and release. Let's turn up the ratio and then turn down the threshold. And let's do more attack. So it can go pretty extreme. I don't think this is trying to emulate any particular type of compressor. It seems pretty standard digital compressor, but useful. For transient control, we've got attack and sustain. An overall gain and a clipping function. And then using the velocity section, we can adjust the filter cutoff. Or the pitch. So it's controlling the pitch as I change the velocity, which can be pretty cool. It's also a volume envelope. When using the pitch envelope section, you need to also turn up the pitch envelope here in the layer section. In Reaper, if we want to add this to a project, it's pretty simple. Right-click, insert virtual instrument on a new track. Select the plugin from the list. And then click yes if you want to load child tracks for this, or if you want just the stereo when you press no. So I've been using the stereo version. Let's have a look at the multi-channel version. So that creates a track for recording the MIDI into, and then 16 stereo channels for audio outputs from the plugin, and they are configured like this, with pre-fader sends out to the different channels already configured for us. Very simple. Because this is pad number one and it's automatically going out to the master, that's going to come out on output one, but we can also set this up so it goes out to output two. And you see in the mixer, that's coming out output two, output five, etc. And then doing that, you have complete control using any other effect that you want for each of the sounds. If you want to process all of your kick drums simultaneously, it's just a matter of selecting all of the drums, which I can do by command clicking, and then setting them all out to output two. And so now each of these pads are going out to output two, and then I can add in EQ, compression, delays, and reverbs, and things like that to affect all of these sounds simultaneously. While it doesn't have internal buses and effects for those buses, it's very simple to just assign the same output and then process that on a track inside the DAW. Now we're going to look at the slicer. So I'm just going to drag in a loop and close the browser, and it automatically slices this loop up. And if we want to add a new slice, it's a shift click. And if we want to remove a slice, you just drag the start or end to one of the edges of another slice, and that will kind of replace it. So let's populate this sampler with a couple different sounds. So if we don't like this slice, we can click on this slice button. It's going to go back to the slicer, and from there we can choose a different sample by just choosing the bounds of that slice. Let's take this one instead. And if we want to add in a fade in, just do this. Or fade out, do that. So that's it for my tutorial on the Speedrum software from Apisonic Labs. It's a very focused drum sampler, and I really love that. There's actually a free version of this, which strips out a lot of the extra things like the effects, and it limits it to 16 pads, but it's also a great entry into Speedrum because it offers a lot of features that some of the other options, like Reaper's built-in samplers, for example, don't offer. So links in the description if you're interested in this plugin. Thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Follow me on Facebook and Twitter. Support the Reaper blog through Patreon, and visit reaperblog.net for a lot more tutorials.